The Premier League. Now, most of you guys won't really know that I've got also a very high interest in the British Premier League. So I thought today I'd just throw in my 5 cents and give you a prediction for the Premier League. At this time when I bring out this video, already the first game has been played and I'll consider that too, but if still something changes, if anybody gets transferred away, I can't really predict that. That's just how the stands are right now. Before we get into the video, I'd like to recommend to all of you join my Discord. It's fun there. We're chatting. I sometimes give some spoilers and I game with people and it's just a fun time. So I'd advise you join me. Link is in the description. So let's get right into the Premier League. Last year, Man City won it and Stoke, West Brom and Swansea went down with the new additions of Fulham, Cardiff and Wolves. So we'll be very interested how they'll do this season. And I'll go from top to from bottom to top, and yeah, let's get right into it. In my opinion, at number 20 comes the newly promoted Cardiff. Even though in the last few seasons usually the promoted teams did quite well, I don't think Cardiff has got it this time. With the new additions of Murphy and Reed, they did well, I guess, and they didn't really lose anybody too important, but a big oof is that they overall don't have a very deep squad and I just can't see them doing very well. I can imagine them going right back down. At number 19 we have Huddersfield. And now Huddersfield did rather well last year, but I just don't think they got it. They got what it takes to stay up. In my opinion, they didn't have a too bad transfer with it, but still I think their last season really overperformed. And this season, the people know what's awaiting them with their high-pressing style, and I just don't think that they have what it takes to stay up, even though they added some good new players as Kongolo and Diakhaby. But they will probably miss Tom Ince, and I just don't think they have what it takes to stay up. Their overall squad depth is rather low. So, number 19. At number 18, again, one of the teams which last season managed to stay up, and that is Brighton Hove Albion. Now, why do I think that they go down? I wasn't too sure about this decision, but I just don't think their new additions really are super strong. They bought in a lot of new players, but none of them are Premier League proven. Now, I'll probably say this guy's name absolutely wrong, but Jahan Baksh, yeah, I guess that's it. Jahan Baksh, they got from the Eredivisie, and he was quite expensive. He might be good, but everybody else, I mean, Bissouma and Bernardo, all just not proven in the Premier League. They can have a good impact. They might not do bad. But I just don't think they have what it takes to stay up. So these are three teams which will go down. Now, who will barely scrape along and won't get relegated? Now, I'm going a bit interesting because I've seen a lot of people predicted this team to do super well. But I don't really think it's very smart that Wolves put in so many new players. I think they have almost a bit too much. They have made almost a bit too much transfers. They got Adama Traore and Diogo Jota, as well as Willy Bolly and Afobe, which, I mean, Afobe could be very good transfer. And I think he might be one of the reasons why they might be keeping up. And otherwise, they've just got like a whole, they just were like, okay, let's buy Portugal. I think they watched a lot of the European Championship. They saw Portugal super well, they right? So, okay, let's get Rui Patricio, let's get João Moutinho. They didn't manage to get Pepe, but still, they were just like, let's just buy up the whole Portuguese league. I'm not sure, I could imagine that the team gets a bit split, and I don't think they have what it takes to actually do super well. And at number 16, the team which last year barely avoided relegation, Southampton. Now, Southampton bought some interesting new players with Vestergaard and Elionusi. And I think they have quite good additions. They might improve a little bit, but the loss of Tadic might hurt them quite a bit. And yeah, I think they still have some problems. This time they didn't lose too many important players. That's why they will stay up, but they won't do very well. At number 15, I rate Watford. Now, Watford an interesting transfer window because they get the young, talented Spanish player Gerard Deulofeu. But that was actually already the big transfers they made. That's about it. And they lost Richard Leeson, I mean, for an astonishingly high amount. I don't think he's worth that amount. And also Amrabat, which was not too bad for them. So I don't really see them doing super well, even though they made a nice transfer plus, but they didn't really strengthen, they rather lost a bit. So I'd say they stay about the same, or yeah, they go down one spot from last year. At number 14, a team which I personally rate rather high, which is Newcastle United. Now, I think they have quite a nice team. They got in some okay-ish players, but they didn't really strengthen enough. I mean, they got Muto, a Japanese striker, and they didn't spend over 11 million euros. So, I mean, that says a lot. They bought some good players, Fabian Schär. That's quite a good job for Switzerland. But they lost good players. They lost Mitrovic, who was a super strong striker. I mean, not for them, but for Fulham, he was. And Michael Merino also, they did lose some players. They didn't really improve a lot, and they should have. Even though Rafa Benitez is going to get the good of the team, but he can get increasingly frustrated with the lack of spendings he can do. So I don't think they will do as good as last year and will go to be the 13th position. At number 13, I guess newly promoted Fulham as the last promoted side. Now, they really got quite the nice improvements, I have to say. They bought Seri, who was chased by the likes of Barcelona and a lot of very top clubs, so he will probably go on, but for the moment, he's got super. I mean, they made a super deal. They got Mitrovic, who did very well for them last year. They also bought the young talent Anguissa from Marseille, and overall, strengthened the team quite well. Alfie Mawson, and they didn't really lose two significant players, just David Button, and yeah, I mean, yeah. More of a second goalkeeper. So I'd say they are a strong candidate, and I think they could take the momentum they had at the end of this last season and, yeah, keep going. They also even still loaned Callum Chambers and Andre Schürrle. So, I mean, they've got a super strong squad if they manage to get the chemistry somehow working among the players. At number 12, we have, I would say, same as last year, Bournemouth. Now, Bournemouth did quite well. Last year they overperformed actually, but this year they did actually strengthen a bit their squad. They got in the likes of Lerma and Rico, but they lost Afobe. But still, I think they strengthened and they have a good manager, so they could do rather well. I think they will stay at the same position at number 11. I would say Crystal Palace also stays in the same position. Under Roy Hodgson, they had a big change in their squad. They made massive improvements. They did super well. They didn't actually lose too many good players, just still some older players like Cabaye and Delaney. Might be a little annoying that they're gone, but still nothing too massive. And they got in Cheikh Okwuegbuyi from West Ham and the very young, good young talent Max Meyer. So I can really imagine them keeping their position and then long term maybe even cementing themselves a little bit higher in the table, the 11th. But with their squad, I think 11th, they should be pleased with that. Now we're breaking into top 10. And who do I think will become 10th? I think, and this stands in the moment, with the extra of playing in Europe, there is Burnley. Now Burnley didn't really, again, didn't lose too many players. They got in some okay players. Matej Vidra and Ben Gibson, as well as Joe Hart, seem to me like good transfers. They strengthened, but they're still not deep enough. I think last year was an exploit for them. They did too well, and this year with Europe, they will feel the toll. I think they'll fall off a little bit, but still, 10th place is still a good achievement for them. And at number 9, I think that Leicester City will fall off a little bit, even though they made some good new transfers, but they did lose Riyad Mahrez and Ame Musa, which will hurt them a lot, as well as Islam Slimani and Alexander Dragovic. All of them are gone. They did get in some quite good new transfers, like James Maddison, the young talent from Norwich, Ricardo Pereira from Porto, and Filip Benković. I think they got some good transfers, but I can't imagine them doing so well. They lost their one of their best players, and I don't think that an aging Jamie Vardy will do as well without the assistance from Riyad Mahrez. So they still will be okay, but they will stay in their position and not move up. Now I predict a little upset here, which is that Everton will only finish 8th. Now why do I think that? Everton last season already didn't perform. This season, the pre-season, they did really bad. And yeah, their transfers, again, they actually made some good transfers. I just don't feel that with their mentality, they can't really come up a lot higher. They got Richard Leeson and Jerry Mina. Actually, I think that's quite a good transfer, as well as Lucas Digne. They didn't get too bad transfers with Kurt Zuma. Andre Gomez really underperformed at Barcelona. But a lot of other players, they got in some quite good players. I just don't think they have what it takes to break top six. I think no other team has accepted the classical top six. But I just think that one team might upset, which is West Ham. Now, West Ham, they really went all out in the market. Not only last season they went out. They only lost Checo Kuyate as a really significant player, and João Mário went to Inter Milan again on loan. But they did get Felipe Anderson. They got Diop as a young, talented central defender. They got Yuar Molenko from Dortmund, who was doing rather well there. As well as a lot of other really good additions, like Jack Wilshere, which they got for free. I could just imagine that team doing really well. I could see that, especially with the new addition of Manuel Pellegrini, I can see that if he keeps that squad together, even though they had a shocking first day against Liverpool, but Liverpool's insane, I could think that they might actually break into top 7. That's my guess. It could go really bad, I'm not sure, but it's a bit of a risky one. I think they could do really well this season. And the top 6, again, I'm going a little bit controversial with these guesses just because I don't want to just be too conservative. I want to give a bit interesting predictions. And I think that Chelsea actually will come 6. Now, they actually didn't do too bad transfers. Again, a lot of Premier League sides actually strengthened. But Chelsea got good new players with Jorginho and Kepa as a young player. But they did lose Courtois. They also got Mateo Kovacic. But I can just imagine that Thibaut Courtois going to Real Madrid in that fashion that he did might cause some unrest in the team. And I just can't imagine him really doing too well, them really doing too well without him. They also sold Bakayoko. I mean, they loaned him to Milan, but he'll be sold off later. As well as Batshuayi has gone to Valencia, even though he's not really featuring in the squad. But still, I just can't imagine doing too well. I just think this is the year where they have a bit trouble adjusting with their new manager, Sarri. I just think they'll become 6. At number 5, again, a little risky move, but I just think that Tottenham Hotspurs is too prone for injuries. If they get injuries on their major players, like especially Harry Kane, or if they lose Dele Alli, or if Hugo Lloris gets injured, they don't really have the backups for them. They're really thin spread. Toby Alderweireld might still leave. There is still some rumours they might still get picked apart. They have a good squad. They might actually make top 4, but I just think this year will be the year they'll fall off a little bit. Even though Pochettino lets them play a really nice style of football, but I just think not this year. This year, again, in typical fashion, Arsenal will become one above them and will become the 4th place. I have faith that Unai Emery might get the best out of the squad, especially with only having to deal with the Europa League. And with some decent new additions, with Socrates, who was a very good player in the Bundesliga with Dortmund, with Bernd Leno, also again strong player from the Bundesliga, as well as Lucas Torreira, who did rather well in their preseason for them, and the seasoned routinier Stefan Lichtsteiner. I just think they did a really nice job in strengthening their team. And the only significant player they lost was Jack Wilshere, which could hurt them a little bit. But I just think with the new manager, Unai Emery, with the new style, I think he does manage to get around this season and they will finish top 4 back in the Champions League. Now it gets quite interesting, who will become 1st, 2nd and 3rd? Will it be the insane Manchester City, who were so strong? Can they continue their run from last season? Can Liverpool, with the new additions, break into the top spots and stay in big competitions for a long time as they just did? And could Manchester United break into these top spots? Can they become champion? Here are my predictions. In my opinion, 3rd place goes to Manchester United. Now, Man United, I don't think they had the best transfer window. They got Fred, a talented player, but my opinion of him isn't too high because he went to Shakhtar and he went with a bit of a money-hungry aspect to it. I'm not too pleased. I think he could do not so well. And they did lose Daley Blind, a good addition to the squad, very versatile. And I can feel like Jose Mourinho can have a very frustrating season, as he's already starting to cry about now. and he's telling he does have too many fixtures, and he's complaining about everything. So I can imagine this is the season where they fall off a little bit. They didn't strengthen off top three. At number two, and now it gets really interesting, between Liverpool and Man City. And in my opinion, Man City will become second, making Liverpool the champions. I just think it's a typical thing. If you become champions, it's super hard to retain that championship spot. And I think that the motivation will go a little bit down. They can't keep it at high pace. They did get Riyad Mahrez, also again, as a veteran in winning the Premier League. And they didn't really sell anybody too significant. They still have a super strong squad. If they won't become second, they will be first. I can imagine Pep getting them out of them. But I also could imagine that Man City can do really well in Europe, which can affect their Premier League season. And at number one, it's a wild guess, and I'm not sure it actually might happen, but you have to have eyes on Liverpool. They strengthened their squad in exactly the right place. They get Alisson, finally a goalie, who can actually do it, and not have a little major breakdown. The Champions League final, the most important competition of the year. I'm looking at you, Karius. Better depth in their squad. They got Naby Keita, a strong centre-back that could be a first-choice centre-back. Fabinho and Xherdan Shaqiri as a second choice for Mo Salah if Klopp wants to actually rest Salah. So I think they could do super well. They didn't lose anybody except to Emre Can, but they kind of replaced him one-to-one with Fabinho. I think Liverpool has what it takes this year. I could imagine them not doing too well in other competitions like the Champions League or the Cups, but I can think they just falling out could do them very well. And I can imagine that Liverpool becomes champion this year. But it's, again, this year, I mean, not this year, I'm doing this for the first time. But I could just imagine that Premier League this year will be a bit of shake-up. Some positions will move. Top six will stay the same. I'd say about the guesses from, let's say, 17 till 10 are super hard to make because there a lot can happen. Small differences. It's not sure who will jump above the other teams. Like Newcastle last year, still jumped up to 15th, even though they were hanging around the likes of 15th place for quite a long time. But yeah, it's hard to guess. I hope I'll look back at this in a year. I hope you guys enjoyed this because this is not my typical kind of content I make on YouTube. So yeah, please subscribe to my channel. Please turn on notifications. I hope you enjoyed this new content. Tell me in the comments if you can deal with it and tell me if you don't like it. Yeah. I just like to do what I want to do. Anyways, enough rambling on now. I wish you guys a nice day, a nice week, and have a great time. Goodbye.